is coming up. Make some noise nationwide. We are getting into it. And it is going to be on Overpass. The crowd here has been amazing today. And we're still in the quarterfinals. The other two, well, the semifinals, they are only coming up later today. And already everybody is fired up. We're starting to fill out this entire stadium. It's amazing.
The nosebleed section is getting full, man. This is so hype right now. I'm just soaking it all in, Anders, man. This is the dream right here. I mean, packed house in North America for the first North American major. It is amazing. And, well, we have one hell of a game to deliver here. One hell of a game to start things off. It is Virtus.Pro versus Luminosity. They're going into their third map now. Still in warm-up, guys. Still in warm-up. So things, you know, we'll see how they develop. But, Anders, let me get your take on this final map. Who do you see coming out ahead here? And I'm just going to throw you right on the bus. Because you always do this to me. It's time to get even, bro.
I mean, I don't know. This is really tough. I think Virtus.Pro and Na'Vi were two of the teams that showed early on when Overpass was released a lot of creativity in play, especially on the T side. Some really good execution towards the V-bomb side. The metagame has changed so much. And with Luminosity winning that second map and the sort of start they had, they managed to close it out 16-10. I think they're going to have the sort of the momentum going into this. I did pick Luminosity to make it to the Grand Finals. I think I have to stick with them. I can't just abandon them here. But honestly, the way the VPS are playing right now, and given that, you know, it was mainly Bialy sort of picking up on Cobblestone and making that work. You know, imagine if the rest of VP decided, actually, we were there on cash, we weren't there on Cobblestone, trying to get time to get back on Overpass. This could be a really scary match, but, you know, have to always pick one team. Luminosity, I think they can make it through here.
You're still sticking with Luminosity?
Yeah. What
we've seen so far hasn't changed it.
Alright. I mean, it almost has, right, but you gotta stick with the original prediction, don't you?
I mean, yeah, exactly. And considering, you know, we're sitting next to the Virtus.Pro cheering section, might be a bit risky.
That's just been
might
amazing.
Might be a bit risky to do this. Still sticking with Luminosity as well. But Virtus.Pro are showing us what they're capable of here, showing us a fantastic match.
People have the hand signs and everything. This is just all working out very nicely. And we should be going into the game in just not too long here.
I'm absolutely adoring the chance as well, man.
And you know, someone in the front seat there is going to be ready for the Na'Vi game, I could tell. That's coming up later as well.
I was standing next to Device as well when I was like outside. I was standing next to Device. I'm like, dude, it's so sick to see so many Na'Vi jerseys around. And he's like, yeah. I'm like, oh, right. Yeah, sorry about that, bro. But that is going to be an amazing semi as well, man.
A semi that might as well have been a grand final. Again,
absolutely.
We've already had Astralis and Fnatic, which also could have been a grand final. This tournament is turning out quite well. And, you know, you did think, I certainly did think, probably this would be an easy run for Luminosity to make it to the grand finals. I mean, you know, defeat VP, they have been in a slump. That's how we introduced this whole series, right? If they do that, then they get to play Liquid. And, I mean, that looked like a straight line. Now, I'm not so sure anymore. I mean, VP have put a lot of doubt in my mind, and they've got the stadium fired up, so I can't imagine this could be anything but good. And, you know, yeah. Overpass is just such a good map to watch as well. So much creative play could be pulled out here, and we don't have many, I think, people in the scene that are more creative than Fallen and Seuss and sort of the Luminosity team.
Yeah.
They have some incredible setups. One of my favorite ones is how if they end up ecoing on the CT side, they will buy just one flashbang. Then they will all stack up around the restrooms and playground area, and they'll pop the single flash out. As soon as anyone engages from the other side, they'll pop the flashbang out, everyone will peek at the same time. I've seen it work a couple of times, and it's a devastating way to play just an eco.
Well, it was a point that was made on the desk earlier by Richard, that these guys just do nothing but, you know, get into this core unit and then eat and breathe. I mean, they just breathe CS, right? That's all they think about. The point where, like, they didn't have internet on a plane over an international flight, and they're all sitting in the same row, so what happens? One of them busts out a laptop, and they start using paint to, like, draw out bomb sites and figure out tactics, you know, just while they're on the plane to events. So they never stop. Somebody comes up with an idea, boom, huddle, start talking it over, start figuring out how they can implement that in their game. I mean, this is why they are one of the top teams in the world now. They just never give up, and they never stop working.
Yeah, you know who? I've been on a plane with one other person who did that ever, and that was Sean Gez.
Yeah, so,
taking out the laptop, the notebook.
Existence is also another one. I mean, you start getting into these legendary leaders.
I swear I hear a couple of people cheering for Sean there, which I think is definitely appropriate. Now, we are going to be headed into the game here. It's Virtus.Pro and Luminosity, so get ready, ladies and gentlemen. It is already live. Snacks and Pasha pushing in to the underpass here, and it's going to be for Moving. Oh, what? He hits that shot, but he's going to go down. Pasha with the refrag. Now the rest of Luminosity coming in with a vengeance. They look to take revenge, but Pasha is still alive back here, getting a second kill in, and now things look really tough for Luminosity. They're a man down. They still have control of the bomb, and they're trying to see if they can actually get this to work. FNX is there. They have a crossfire VP. They're walking into it. Taz comes flying through. Pasha with one more headshot. It's going to make it a triple, and Fallen goes down, and VSE off to a fantastic start here, winning the pistol on overpass.
There are the biceps, man. There's Pasha. He had a very poor performance on Cobblestone. This is a perfect start for him in the pistol on the map to decide it all. For him to come alive in such a key round, that's huge. You can see, I mean, Cuban walking over, immediate fist pump. You know, just like, time to get to work. And Pasha, he's here. That's what it's all about. 1-0 lead now for Virtus.Pro on the favored side of this map as well, on the counter-terrorist side. And Luminosity, once again, a bit of a bumpy road for him here. They go for the force buy as well. Fallen, the only one who doesn't go for Kevlar just so he can prioritize that AWP. But the rest of his team, they've invested the money. Now we have to see, is Fur capable of hitting that headshot again? Not quite. Tomko, however, has caught out Taz on short B. So this is going to get a little tricky here. Pasha, he's backing off. He's got the M4 as well.
How did that grenade not kill him? How did he hit that shot? This is already turning into a bit of a crazy round with Luminosity having a one-man lead and Fur just holding the angle. Pasha is a single bullet away from death, so the round could fall apart in just a second here. They got so much time and they've got him boxed in. They know it as well. They're waiting for him to make the mistake.
This is like the longest, it feels like the longest two rounds ever, man. This is crazy. We still have a minute left. Feels like it's already been 2 minutes worth of fight down here in Connector. Pasha, now it's because they've just decided they're going to come for him. Doesn't hit the headshot. He gets overwhelmed. And so a man advantage now. A rifle picked up, two rifles, in fact. One on Taco with that FAMAS. And now Luminosity, they have a real chance at turning things around here. They're going to, they actually decide to rotate back into T-spawn. They're giving themselves some options, and it is going to be going towards that B site. Snacks, however, is in position.
He is, and he's got the scout. They actually both have scouts. That's what I'm going to point out. That's a little bit creepy, isn't it? Trying to hold on a 2v4 with just a scout here. It's going to have to be some really good shots. Fallen doesn't have armor, so he could go down quick to a scout, but the rest, except for Fur, they might be able to take a shot here. Snacks, there's a headshot, everything heads down, that's how you do it. Second comes in, Fallen very low again. The lack of armor, they're really damaging with the scout. They can't shoot through that box, it's just not possible. Too much wood going on down there. It's going to be a 2-1-3. Bomb is planted, and Snacks really wants to make it out of the sniper spot. He's going to be able to do just that. Neo coming in to help out. And that bomb ticking, they don't, oh, they have a kit on Neo actually, this might be possible.
It comes down to who takes the fights, and well, Taco, he gets a drop on Neo, and now it's so difficult here for Snacks, but he hits the headshot. Little does he know, however, exactly, he's not alone. There's a man on high. He's got the kit, and he's going to go for the fake, and he's going to get the running gun onto Fur. And now it's all on Fallen, who has the M4, but no Kevlar. Bomb ticking down, pressure mounting Snacks. He's just not going to have the time. Fallen has got nerves of steel, doesn't show himself, and it's just going to go Luminosity's way. They lose the pistol, but they will get the force. Both players going up with the bomb, but that doesn't matter. Luminosity, they accomplished something here, Anders, and that is to win a very difficult round versus VP.
How do you not peek that? If you're Fallen, how do you just stay cold as ice like that? If he had just stuck the defuse there, that would have been it.
Does that mean that Snacks isn't a pro? Is that what's going on here? First on fake
on. I don't know. I can't even imagine having to make that decision in a third map here. Well, we do have VP without any armor, some upgraded pistols, and that's about it. LG bringing it back very quickly early on here.
Taz has got a bit of a clever spot here with the CZ. Shoulder peek, but first gonna lead the way. Both SMGs are here, and boom, total annihilation, and FNX with a follow-up on Pasha. Little do they know, this is a stack, but it's going perfectly here for Luminosity. All three kills, swift and clean, come through, and Neo, he's up in sniper, but he can't have too much of an impact with this P250. If he had a dig, maybe. Fur's gonna come for him anyways. Nice shot from Neo. Perfectly lined up, catches him midair. Oh, we'll find Snacks lurking in CT, or in T-spawn rather, and Snacks wins that duel. He gets the AK. And Fallen, he has a tendency of doing this, man. He wants to go out and hunt solo, but Now he risks giving up the rifle. They will save it in the end. It's Taco who will find the kill. Or rather Cold, actually. Never mind.
Well, Neo is going to be alone in a one-on-three here, so just hoping maybe to run into someone, get an exit in the round. That would definitely help a little bit. He's already done some damage and might as well do what they can to keep the terrorist side economy as low as possible. We're going into the fourth round. Still be a bit tricky for Virtus.Pro. I mean, when you're on the CT side, this kind of an early sort of break in the usual pattern is definitely very annoying, and they won't have enough money to buy in the upcoming round here, so saving the MAC-10. It's better than nothing, surely.
That's fine, right? I mean, you give yourself a little bit of a chance. Neo actually has has a decision to make. Does he want to just force the Kevlar to give himself a little bit more fighting power here, a little bit more staying power, or does he just stay on the MAC-10, save hard? I think the plan is to just save as much as possible for this next round. They need all the nades on the CT side to just hold off Luminosity when it comes to it. Single smoke on Snacks along with the Deeg, a couple of flashes, and that MAC-10 on Neo, and we'll see where he decides to position himself to get the most out of it. And that is going to be on the B site for now. And it seems like Virtus.Pro now, they just really want to put the pressure here on Luminosity. Luminosity keep taking over sewers, they keep trying to take over Connector. And VP, they've decided, no, we're not going to let that happen. We're going to put up a bit of a fight here.
Well, Taz to go down. Taco with a really good double. They're actually trying to see if they can aggressively push him out. And he's just getting all the kills. Viali going down. That was with the side of the Monster Tunnel as well. And Snacks alone in Sniper with the Deagle. So doesn't, oh, they might be coming his way eventually. It seems like Fallen's falling back with the bomb. He's gonna make his way down. He might have a chance to get one or two kills here, but he obviously can't make it out. Cold and Fur on the other side, sort of behind him, so he is fairly boxed in here.
And this has gone on long enough, exactly, for Snacks to start worrying about the flank coming in. Anybody made it up onto that A site? Fur, Cold, they're kind of hanging around in mid right now. They're hunting Snacks, but they will make their way down into the hallways, into the tunnels fairly soon, and that's where they'll run into Snacks. And Snacks, I mean, natural Snacks fashion, right? Making use of the smoke, trying to close the angles. But man, look at this, Luminosity. Are they having a powwow right now? Like, they just refuse to actually take the risk to push onto the site until they figure out where this guy's going.
I mean, they only take some damage on Taco, but he took three players with him, so it could also just be that it's going to be really annoying to Virtus.Pro, you know, when you're in a one-on-five round, you know, you're just going to be like, come on, you know, just push on and let's play the next round. We don't want to wait around forever. You've kind of already won this round. AWP is being picked up on Snacks. Fallen has his on the other side. And we're going into the fifth round here with Luminosity leading 3-1 in spite of losing the pistol. So it's a good start. Very good start for them.
They've completely turned it around. And now it's just reverse, all the pressure on VP. FNX is going to take point instead of Fur in Connector. He is backed up by Fallen with that AWP. And because VP have been putting up a fight here in Connector round after round, he's looking to see if Pasha's going to show up. But VP choose to actually go for a little bit more of a passive hold. They didn't push all the way up to top mid. Instead, they're kind of holding halfway. Snacks with the AWP is just hoping, waiting for somebody to make a mistake up there. It's just not going to happen. Luminosity are content to sit back and wait. And just make a little bit of noise to try and get some utility out of Virtus.Pro.
I like the fact that VP, they do keep control of restrooms here. I think that's important. They gotta make sure that Luminosity at least fight to get it. They gotta use some grenades, gotta spend some time. If they just give it to them for free, that's definitely not worth it. So, still sticking around a bit is Pasha. Snack's gonna just go and check long real quick. And Fallen, trying to clear out on his side here. But this is turning into a very, very slow round for Luminosity on the T side. And you have to worry about that a little bit if they end up running the clock too low right now.
That's my main concern. This is where it kind of flips on Luminosity because they're just waiting to see if VP are going to show themselves and if they can get that free kill to make it easier to get onto a site. But now they're starting to run low on time, 30 seconds left, and they haven't seen anybody from Virtus.Pro. It's a full compliment, and Snacks finally going to show that he has that AWP, goes for the flick, but he misses it. But now Luminosity in position to take over this A site. They've got the smokes necessary for the play, even a Molotov on first. We'll see where he decides to use it.
This is going to be really scary. Snacks is on the corner of the box. That Monoton X is clearing out the corner where Pasha was standing. They're going to make their way through, but Pasha jumping through the smoke, taking up for looking for the flick. There's Cold Sierra going down next. Pasha with the double kill. Look at the clock here. 7 seconds left. Luminosity, they left themselves no time at all. And VP are going to pick up the second round here. Fallen trying to stay alive, but Neo looking for him, and he's going to get the kill. He actually takes out Fallen after the clock has basically run out. Wow, that's the AWP lost.
No bonus money for Fallen because he lives through that clock. Instead, it's going to tap into the bank of the rest of his team. And luckily for them, they actually had quite a bit of money coming into this round. So they are able to recover. But yeah, losing Fallen, that's zero money. That's no good. Huge kill from Neo with the hunts there. But you're right, I mean, this is the issue. This is how VP can actually play against Luminosity. They're like, okay, if you want to sit and wait, we'll do the same. We just won't give you a kill. And then you have to go for the full execute with the full complement of the defense on the site waiting for you there. So this time around, they're going aggro. FNX does bring it back by taking out Pasha. So the advantage gained by Snax, it's lost instantly after.
If he shoots through that wall, he just tried to do it once. I'm getting a little bit nervous here, because Snax seems to be sort of tuned into that higher level that he sort of seems to hit every once in a while, and that's not something that Luminosity maybe need right now. It's still early on, and if they win this round here, again, they're going to be resetting almost all of VP's economy, and that's what they're looking for. They know they have them right at the edge. This is, statistically at least, a CT-sided map.
Mm-hmm.
So the start here for the Brazilian side is very good.
I might be thinking we've had, you know, some luck over on that B site, so let's go ahead, start pushing towards there once again. There are two players ready and waiting for them, however, Neo and Viali. And Neo is still holding that AWP. 45 seconds left. Perfect time for the incendiary. That's going to force Luminosity back. That's going to buy even more time here for the CT side. And Neo's going to catch the pick onto Fallen. Straight up 1v1 up battle. And Neo comes out ahead. And now Taco's going to run right in. He actually misses the shot, Neo. But Viali's there to save the day. And Viali's going to get the punish on the Cold. Who's going to land the shot? How is Cold still alive? But more importantly, they just got completely whittled down, Luminosity. It's down to Cold alone in a 1v4. And there's just no way. Viali comes right through to his death. But with 20 seconds left, Cold, he's just not going to be able to win this round. He has to back off once again.
Maybe not a necessary fight for Bailey to take in through the smoke like that, but you've got to give him a lot of credit for saving Neo there. And he did it on Cash as well, so he's turning out to be quite a good bodyguard there. But Cold, going to be saving the AWP. It's going to tie the scoreline here. Make it 3-3. And again, we are in the final map in this series.
They have a bit of a difficult decision to make here, Luminosity. Do they want to keep playing with this? Keep pushing? They should have the money for a buy on two of their players. AK on Fallen, if he wants, he can drop that for a mate. FNX just enough for the Galil Kevlar, but it is a bit of a shoestring buy here. So Luminosity now, they're going to be feeling the hurt. It's VP who have control once again after losing in the forest. They come right back into it fighting, and this is really shaping up to be the perfect third map. Both teams so balanced. And all these players getting shot. Pushed off, going for the big spray, and he's not going to win it. Fallen is there, and FNX takes out Snax. In the blink of an eye, Luminosity now have a huge advantage in this round.
Wow, you show yourself here, that grenade not even going to go for the window. That it's possible to do that, but he just had the slightly wrong angle there. 5 versus 3, and it really looked like Pasha's spray got caught a bit on the side of the pipe there. So that's obviously very unfortunate. Fallen is low on health, but unless they could find a big kill here, VP, and I wish they would go and look for it. I think right now you need someone to maybe either for Taz or Bailey to group up and go and peek somewhere and take a fight, or Neo to go on some sort of long ranger mission and just try and see if he can make this work. Because if they just wait around, then VP have 5 members with which to execute onto a bomb site. You'd have to be slightly mad to think that you were going to win that either 2-on-5 or 1-on-5. Neo, he does have the AWP, and I did sort of pick him to have sort of a nostalgia game here, so still excited.
They're running out of time here, Luminosity, though. 30 seconds, and there's the shot. Neo's been spotted. Fallen, he's got the angle, and he unscopes just as FNX goes past. Or that was fur, but still,
I mean,
now the push begins.
He surely shouldn't be able to defend this. He's also coming in there, making their way around the corner. Neo picking up one. He's going to try and throw it once again. They are getting close here. 15 seconds left. Taz going to be going down. Neo looking for the shot. They're really close. And FNX will be able to drop him. And there's a second shot coming through. Beautiful round here from FNX. Triple, in fact. And Luminosity take the round lead.
And throw VP's economy into shambles. Taz, he's sitting on 1 kill, but he's got the most money, 5,500. The rest of them are all floating around the 2 to 3K mark. It's not quite enough to go for a big buy here for Virtus.Pro. And this is ideal for Luminosity. Let VP win a couple of rounds. Great. But so long as they're close, VP aren't going to have the money to go for the full buy right back into it. Unless they go for the force buy. And this is crazy from Virtus.Pro.
I'm not digging this, Semler.
This is so scary. They're risking a lot in the first half. This is several rounds on the line now for Virtus.Pro.
This line is really thin here, but I feel like this is either genius or it's complete madness, and I'm tilting toward the madness side of things right here. Even if Luminosity got 5, you could definitely do. They could get 5 or 6 rounds on this. I think even if this one is 8-7, I still think, you know, VP are in it, but they gotta be careful right now that they're not giving away too much. That scout shot not connecting, and Fallen, he was ready for that one.
Oh yeah, it was perfect. Very well baited. It works perfectly. Taz has dropped Snacks, his AWP. And Snacks, he has to take a risk. This is why he's so far forward right now. It's a bit of an off angle. Luminosity might not expect it when they come around the corner, and the time that it would take to shift your crosshair over onto Snacks, that would do it. And yep, Snacks finds the easy kill on a Fallen and brings it back to a 4-on-4. But there's still a massive lead here for Luminosity as far as the utility is concerned. They have the nades to execute onto this site. But VP, there's currently 2 of them waiting, and Neo getting into a very clever corner here. Up close with the 5-7, he can do huge damage when they come around that angle.
Especially because they hear that AWP from the Snacks. I mean, I don't think they can. The thing is, they're all going to be focused on the AWP. They don't want to run into that. So now they've already been on this part of the map. Neo's actually walking into their territory behind them. But the 5-7, he takes up one. He continues to shoot. Steals the AWP, turns around, but he can't get the flick. And Snacks is going to be going down. Luminosity fighting their way out. That happened in the space of 2 seconds. And Bayali and Taz, 2-on-3 here. Still got 10 seconds left. The bomb is going to be going down, and Taz runs right into FNX.
They're not sure where the second man is, but it's incredible how close Luminosity are cutting it at the end of these rounds. Every time pushing onto a site with, 25 seconds left, that just leaves you such a small margin for error. Single mistake, big kill. Neo had the potential to make the big play. If he'd have picked up that second frag with the AWP, it would have changed everything. But now it's Bialy trying to go for the big one. And he's actually kind of caught in the corner here. Steps out, gets the pre-fire on FNX, what a shot! And Taco now the last man alive, he's got the AWP. And it seems to me like Bialy realizes he's just not going to have the time for the defuse, so he decides to back off, save the M4. Maybe he can take Taco with him, he spots him out! But it's still the round for Luminosity in the end.
That second peek with a FAMAS of all weapons, and I think you could tell that he was looking for the AK, but it got, you know, I think he himself sort of managed to shoot it away from himself. 5-3. And Virtus.Pro, without much of an economy, this is a nuts peak, isn't it?
So sick. Oh, good evening.
Well,
random good evening. I don't know where I was going with that one, but there you have it. I mean, right now I'm just rocked because VP, they're all over the place. Bialy saves the M4, but he's going to have an impact in this round with it. The rest of his teammates are pretty much hard ecoing because they sacrificed so much of their economy in the last round.
Wow, look at this play here. Snacks pushed up, follow up, flashbang, Fallen, making it around the corner, but Coltsuo there to help out his teammate with the AK. That was going to be a pretty bad start if they would have lost that AWP. Bialy, he saved the rifle last round, and he gets a kill with it in this round, but again, he has to save it one more time, and there's no point in giving it up trying to 2v4 them right now.
Well, it's going to get difficult here for Coldzera. He's going to Boston, he sees Neo coming from a mile away, and that's one of them gone. Now it's down to Bialy, and again, Bialy, he has to change how he wants to play this, because if he can survive with this M4, that would be big for him. He can drop that to a teammate in the next round, means that his teammate can get full nades. It would make a big difference, but he needs to survive to do that. And he does win out versus Cold, so nice shot there, making it a little bit more expensive here for Luminosity. He is spotted, however, FNX is on the hunt, and Bialy needs to react in time, and he does! Big spray!
But
draws him down to 2.
Also, Taco's walking up behind him. I mean, Bialy just continuously having to try and defend this rifle, but he's already got the triple kill, so why not continue at this point here? Again, you mentioned this earlier, Fallen not afraid to take the fight, even as they're winning the round, and it sometimes costs them now. He's got the AWP on the other side, Bialy gonna walk right in, and they do lose the rifle. So a bit of a shame, but still a lot of damage done to LG's economy, and they can still buy on the VP side. And I gotta say, the VP cheering section has become just a bit quiet. I think they need it right about now.
It's true though. It is true. Just a little bit quiet.
It's always dangerous when the other team is allowed to sort of shut down, you know, the fans a bit here, but starting to get a bit alive again, and that's obviously good news.
You know who are the kings of that? Fnatic, right?
Yeah.
Luminosity. They're showing us that they're capable.
Gonna be on the edge of long here. It's a good, actually, triple setup. There are 3 men that can peek this angle, but that's absolutely crazy. Bialy, who's been playing so well, didn't stand a chance there, and there was not even any chance for a follow-up.
Well, now there's the opening. Both teams low on utility, but the man advantage is going to be huge here for Luminosity. Snacks. He's trying to set it up, trying to... Oh, clever flash, and that works! Fallen. Full blind, has to fall off that angle. Really close call, but Luminosity now, they have control connector, so they can go either way. It's only Neo on B site with that AWP. No support yet. Snacks is actually going to be rotating down, probably to get into position in Sniper, just to lend him a hand, but it's all on Neo now, and he's taking such a forward position. He will be able to fall back, however, and now things get interesting.
I mean, if they made the breakthrough to B, how is he going to hold it that close with the AWP? He's got Snacks with him now, so that's certainly going to help. The barrels are not going to be able to be occupied by anybody, because that Molotov that Fur is holding in his hand, that's going to land over there. So no one can stand there, they don't even have to check it. Neo now, I think a lot rides on him. They are making their way up the ramp, they're getting very close. Maybe it's a shot here, he could be going down, but he drops first. Snacks has fallen, so he is still in a very tight position here. It's going to be Pasha going down next, now all on Taz and Neo, and they try and deny the plant, but it's going to go down to the last second. Taco doing what he came to do. It's a 2-on-3 still, and they need to get this defuse home. Tabs hit once. FNX, no peeking, just bold. They're not actually showing it. So Taz getting the kill, but they can't expect it. And now FNX finally coming out of that corner. Neo, he does not have a kit picked up, and this is going to be lethal. He takes the first shot in, but Fallen trying to make it his way around the corner. He will. There's still no kit. He can't pick one up the ground, and Fallen hits a shot close range with the pistol. And it will be Luminosity at 7-3. Wow, what a close round.
These are all so close, Anders. It's not like 4 rounds ago was the last time that Luminosity survived with more than 2 players alive. Otherwise, it's just coming down to 1v1s, 1v2s. It's just nuts to see. But Luminosity keep coming out ahead in the clutch scenarios, and now they're up on 7 rounds here on their T side of Overpass. It's Virtus.Pro who are just straggling behind, trying to catch up. 3 rounds for them. An eco round here for VP again as they get their economy reset. So, Snacks taking the fight. He's going to be moving very close up to top mid, but that smoke going down, it's usually a tell. And Fallen, he's well aware. He knows to check around the edges of it because there's a lot of clever spots he can get into. But, wow, outplayed! Snacks just shuts him down.
Fallen has got to be shaking his head at that. It's not how you want to get entried on a round like this here. I think VP are actually in a position where they need to make this 8-7. I think the next 5 rounds in a row, so because they only have pistols here and no armor, it'd be a good way to spark a comeback. But at least in a fun position down by the tunnel here. I wish he was sort of a little bit further up against the wall. He's definitely going to check that, and he will be able to get the kill. I thought maybe he had been sliding up into the corner, because you could do that, but not this time. Taz missing an opportunity. Finally, Snacks coming in and getting that kill. Did he wallbang that through the, or did he actually open the door?
I think he opened the door. Right. That would have been a bit too next level there for Snacks, even for Snacks. Now Pasha is on a mission. He's back here in T-Spawn. It just seems like now VP, they're going to be setting up to try and catch the exits, make it expensive for Luminosity. If they can get a single more kill, that will apply at least a little bit of pressure on Luminosity's economy, make sure that doesn't get out of control, because one player will be force-buying. They won't be able to just drop guns all over the place. But still, Snacks, we actually get the one dig? Yeah, he spots out Cold. That gives away his positioning. Wow, Cold is just so ballsy. He's like, oh yeah, even if you got a dig, I'll still go ahead and just face you. No worries. AWP, that's some confidence in his ability to get the shot. And now Taco and Cold will be able to back out. Easy situation there for Luminosity to take control of, and Pasha will be able to save an AK, so that's actually a great find for him.
A little bit at the end of the round, but we're still looking at an 8-3 scoreline here. The best that VP could do is win the next 4 in a row, make it 8-7, and I mean, if they win the pistol in the second half, it's still doable. Look at this crowd.
Yeah, this is sick. Love it. Double op play coming in for VP, though, with their backs to the wall. This is it. They're going for the big guns. And this is when Luminosity decided to change up the pace, perhaps. Gathered up outside of sewers, they know that Virtus.Pro have been challenging here, trying to get control of this part of the map, and so Luminosity, they gear themselves up to just go head-on into any kind of defense the VP has set up, and currently there are 3 players here for Virtus.Pro. 1-for-1 trade so far, Cold brings it back, but Neo still behind the pillar, he's gonna be able to pick him off. Looking for the next shot, he's gonna catch a nade in hand! Huge plays coming in from Neo. He's holding the line, and he nearly misses that one as well.
An incredible 2-for-1 shot, and now it's a 2-on-3. If Fallen going to bring someone back, even everything that Neo has done, is it going to be quite enough here? Takes a blind shot through. He's got the orb. He's going to be jumping through. No scope, not connecting. Neo is looking for more. He needs it. They need it, but he's going to go down. FNX will get the shot, and now it's all on Snacks here. 1-on-2. He's controlling the bomb, but he goes down to Fallen. And Luminosity, they want that semi-finals.
How close does it have to get?
Look at this second second shot coming in from Neo. This is the first one. And the next one.
And this one here. Slight point blank. Just catches Taco with the nade in his hand.
Unbelievable.
And I think Fallen actually shot Taco in the back there, trying to pick Neo off. So just chaos for a second, but the true beauteous one there is the near frag, right? Where he just jumps in and barely misses the no-scope.
I thought he even got the tag on the player behind that one on the slope, but didn't look like it. That's going to be Fallen taking out Passion.
Nade.
I think what's happening, headshot. I think what's happening right now to Luminosity is they're entering that zone where everything works. It doesn't even matter if you lose a couple of plays early on, you still make it work.
Yeah, it's the individual plays that are coming through. And Fallen with the key shots in the last round. Now, well, Virtus.Pro, Neo, as we can see, you know, just trying to do the best that he can, and he's still on point. That was a sick shot on Defer, but now Cold is getting control of Long, just wrapping all on in, and he can actually cause a bit of a distraction here because Luminosity aren't fully committed to the A site. They have control of Connector now, which means that they can go either way. So this all comes down to the timing here for Cold. If he comes around this corner and catches Neo out of... No, not even. Nobody's actually there. Neo's down in Sniper already. They're seeing this play. I mean, Virtus.pro are getting prepared for a B push.
And even if it is a B push, because Cold is behind, it's going to be rough. But actually, they're falling back. They're putting the Molotovs, the grenades in, pretending that it is. And as they fall back, they catch Snacks as well.
Yeah.
And he might have been the one player that could have saved this round for VP. Now,
exactly.
It's gone horribly wrong, hasn't it? It is going to be 9-3 here. And Cold Zero picking up Neo. It's all on Taz. And there's nothing that we can really do at this point. Cold just on the hunt, getting the double kill, making it 10-3.
Yeah, and Cold, I mean, he's not even top right. He's tied for the top with FNX right now, who's sitting on 12 kills as well. Neo at 12 for VP, but then it just steeply drops off from there. Snacks, Bialy, Pasha, everybody trying to catch up to him, but he's definitely leading the charge. I mean, it's a fantastic performance from Neo, the fact that he can stay neck and neck with Luminosity, who are currently sitting on 10 rounds on their T side. VP only on 3. Neo doing the best that he can to keep VP in this, but it's just not enough. He needs his teammates to start waking up here, to start landing some shots. And they decide to go for the quasi-buy here, Virtus.pro. A couple of pistols, some Kevlar, some nades. They're preparing for the next round.
I mean, next round is the last of the half here. This is turning really ugly. Snacks flashing himself through that smoke, which they put up from CT spawn. So it's still definitely a very cool idea. Cold Zero well aware that could be someone here.
So yeah, well, and Cold is still just so on point. It's the annihilate Snacks. And the stack here for VP on this B site, they're hoping that Luminosity really haven't shown much love to A. So naturally, Virtus.pro are just hoping to catch them out here. Bialy with the peek, Taco taking some damage, and it's getting risky for him. He has to back off, and he is going to be able to fade away here. Teammates do have control of mid as well, and they can start pushing up. He only saw the two, but that's not enough to be a tell. You know, that's not enough to say, actually, this is a B stack. Fur charging onto A and not seeing a single person, though, that'll give it away. And there's the rotation. Neo runs right into a bullet. And now Luminosity once again have full control of the situation here.
Yeah, they're playing this one so solidly. You could tell that they came well prepared for overpass. Playing it against VP. Pasha going down. The double Cold Zero looking for a bit more. It's going to be FNX to steal that kill. Cold and FNX top fragging. 14 kills on Cold. FNX at 13 and then goes into Neo at 12. But the rest of VP, maybe Snacks could be exempt in them violently, but it drops off a bit too much there at the end. And we're at an 11-3 scoreline here. The South American team just showing us what they're made of.
Double off play here for VP. And well, why not? They need to go for something big. They've made this a core strat for them for themselves as well, and it's such an expensive one. But they just need code for this purpose to be able to afford everything that they need here to try and get this last round. They're desperate to get it as well. If it goes to 12-3, Luminosity, they're pretty much on the home stretch. VP need to stop them at 11. And we are about to have a fight in connector, maybe, as they come into sewers. This could get hairy. There's a little bit of a cross stack going on here. VP, they have two players waiting. Neo with the AWP. He's going to get the wallbang. Shout out to FNX as well. And they have no idea that Taz is holding close. Luminosity, if they try and challenge Neo, it's going to get nasty. Yali is there on short. And the defense so far holds.
Look at Fuzz walked up behind him. He's ready. He wants more kills. Flashbang going through. Nice. Oh, they're stabbing together. It's going to be Snacks going down Fur. Cutting him with the gut knife. And it's going to be Cold Sierra next in line. Dropping Pasha. Oh, my God. Luminosity. A way to humiliate Virtus.Pro here in the quarterfinals. And making their way a message to Liquid, who right now gotta be fearful watching this performance. First on the side, he sees the gun barrel before the player, and that's gonna be Taz and Neo now trying to save this first half, even just a little bit at the end. But what a mad way to start a round. Fur gonna get the kill, and it will be a 12-3 finish in favor of Luminosity on the terrorist side of Overpass. Absolute madness.
I can't get over that, man. That is ridiculous. At least Snacks had a chance. They did go into a knife fight. They both had guns, but they went for a knife fight instead.
Don't know if anyone ever has ever done a gentleman's knife fight, but that was only the closest you could get to it. My God.
And it's a full house here in Columbus. And yeah, you can see the pressure now. This start. I mean, VP... the tension that they're feeling, it's all mounting as they are just so far behind going into this second half. I'm trying to make out the chant now. What is it? Nope.
I think a little bit of everything somewhere at this point here. Just all going into it. 12-3. This one of these rounds early on, if Neo gets both these kills,
yeah.
That was when the score was 4-3, right? If Neo gets that, both those kills in, it could definitely be working out.
I mean, Neo's showing that his game is there, but it's just not enough. He wasn't able to hard carry. And I hope that we stay on this long enough to see the smoke attempt, because that one, that was just madness. The Fallen getting stuck in that corner. For Neo to go for this, this is why Thor and Richard, they're of the opinion that he was the greatest CSGO, or not CSGO, 1.6 player of all time, because he just had this way of approaching the game.
Tag me into that.
Yeah, tag you into that. I mean, we just saw a bit of it right there. To just go for the jump, smoke, point blank, off shot. Had he pulled that off, it would have been one of the biggest plays of the tournament so far.
Well, we're very close now. The countdown has ended, and we are going to go into the final stretch of this best of three quarterfinals. We are here in Columbus, Ohio, and so far it's been amazing. And now we got to see. I mean, Semler, you were selling at this angle earlier on that, you know, the comeback on Cobblestone.
Mm-hmm.
It looked realistic. I'm not going to lie. It looked realistic at the end. Do you want to try and push us that way again? Is it going to happen?
It's hard to make that sell, man. It really is. They have three rounds to work with, and Luminosity are on the favorite side of this map, and Luminosity are going to be the ones fired up after Fur's play, after Cole just leading the way into every fight, FNX hitting all of his shots. Everything is lining up here for Luminosity to make it into the semifinal of this North American Major. Fur, aggressive push from him. What an angle. VP had no idea.
But he also had no backup, and I was going to say no way of making it up, but he did anyway. You think if you get caught in that corner, then, you know, one Glock shot is, and you'll be slowed down a bit, and that'll be it. But it worked out just fine. Neo is going to be setting up a smoke I'm not sure if I've seen before. I'm assuming this is going to land somewhere on the B-bomb site?
Yes.
Wow. So, okay. Some preparation going into this. That's quite... you're going to be able to see that all across the map, but will you know what's actually happening? That's the big thing. Fallen, I think, could have definitely seen the smoke, and he's actually rotating back in anyway, so probably didn't. They do think there's going to be a B-push by Ali's down there making noise. Well, what an elaborate strategy coming out of the Polish side here. Cold Sierra going to take care of it. Fallen now coming back to the bomb site, thinking, wait a minute, that smoke, it just didn't turn out how we expected. Taz is going to be going down. Fallen has been dropped. Snacks is next in line. If Luminosity win this round, you got to expect the Polish team can't really make it back. Neo being dropped as well by FNX, and now Pasha all alone. He takes one, two, looking for a bit more. He's got 9 bullets in the Glock, and it's not enough here. Fur will be able to drop him, and Luminosity Now 10 rounds ahead of VP.
And that's so incredibly frustrating for Pasha. If his teammates could have just stayed alive a little bit longer, the backstab would have been beautiful. He would have just come right crashing into them. Luminosity would have been focused on a different part of the map, and it would have been just, you know, VP walking away with the round. But instead, it's a 10-round lead now for Luminosity. That's what's on the table here. That is what's happening. 3 rounds away, Luminosity. And they have all the edge. And while VP, yeah, they aren't wasting any time, Anders. It's the straight force buy from them. Pistols, nades, and a single AK picked up for snacks. And it's just all or nothing. They cannot allow Luminosity to get up to 14 rounds. Just so little room to maneuver throughout the rest of this half. And VP, I mean, it's just they need a flawless game here. So might as well start now.
FNX is the one trying to make a bit of a play here. Just gonna smoke it off, in fact. Not too much of a fight being put up. It's a very defensive round coming out of VP so far. I do want to say, because we just saw the camera shot there, I've actually met a lot of people already who are bringing their kids here, where the parents come into the stadium and watch. That's super cool. So, I mean, I'm happy that the parents are also getting a bit involved. That's it's a nice way to introduce someone to a cool game here. Snacks is going to be going down early on. That was falling to pick up the kill. Not the best start for Virtus.Pro. That is under a tremendous amount of pressure here. LG are just 3 rounds away from making it to the semis.
And there's Bialy. He brings it back, catches for FNX out of position. Not the best gun. Bialy with the second headshot on the Tech 9. He's looking for the next one. He's down to 10 HP, and Furry, he's got to give it up. Because Neo's flanking him from long, and Neo through the smoke will hunt him down. 2-man lead now for VP going onto this site. Cold, it's time to show up, and he's not going to do it. Taz and Neo working together will find the kill. And it's all on Taco now, and he gets a huge spray. Taz dropped down to 16 HP. Neo getting that bomb down. Pasha there to watch their backs, and they have all the utility as well. It's still a smoke on Pasha to buy even more time here to make life difficult for Taco.
I don't think he's thinking about winning the round, but I mean, again, all the damage, the damage done. Now they're on board with this. They want to see how far the South Americans can push it here, but Taz is going to be able to shut it down, and it will be a fourth round for the Polish side. This is I feel like this is an even harder comeback than what they were presented with on Cobblestone. Things have got even worse.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. And they're going for the force by Luminosity. Yes, granted, they'd be in a double eco scenario, but they are really going to commit. They're going to go crashing right into Virtus.Pro. What did they actually decide to do with this force? That's the question. VP, they should be aware that this is a risk, and they should be playing fairly passively here. But to run head first into mid, this could be a catastrophe for VP. And instead, it's going to be Luminosity trying to set up a little bit of a trap in connector. There has been movement there so far, so why not? And in the meantime, looks like it's just Fallen who's holding in restrooms in mid, trying to watch his teammates' backs, basically. Because if his teammates were able to pick somebody off down there, anybody in mid would try and go in and try and get the refrag. Fallen would then be there in position to actually stop that from happening. And you can see how all the pieces kind of fall into place. But now this is going to get a little tricky for Luminosity, because Virtus.Pro, they're closing in.
Neo with that same smoke that he put up from earlier. Always enjoys seeing something new. See if they have more tricks that are actually coming through here. Barrel showing, Fallen picking up one. He had more of a gun than the other pistol. That could have been interesting here, but they're going to be able to trade very favorably. He finally goes down to Cold Syrup, and it's still a 2-1-2, even though Cold is a click away from death, and Pasha's going to be the one to, Taz's going to be the one to deliver it there. And Taco on the bomb sign, still 45 seconds, and they should wait for each other here. There's no reason to fight Taco at the time.
Down to 4 HP, Bialy going to hit the headshot in the end. Can't take it. Way too close.
It's getting really scary.
And what a round. Luminosity, they were just like never ending coming out of the connector there. Virtus.Pro, like, okay, now we killed that guy. That's got to be it. Nope, wait. Still Cold there to wreck our day. To make it close. Luckily for Pasha, he hits the headshot on Cold. Otherwise, Taz, Cold might not have gone out for that super aggressive kind of face if he had a little bit more HP to work with. He could have taken a little bit more of a drawn out fight with Taz and maybe come out ahead.
I wonder what would have happened if Fallen had the first kill and just fallen back. So then the other people would have come out of the stairwell, and then suddenly they would have had three members there sort of crossfire the rest of EP. But, you know, hindsight, it's much easier to play Counter-Strike, you know, reverse when you know what's happening. It's just always easier. 19th round is where we're at. This is, again, the third map. If you are just joining in, if you're just tuning into the broadcast here, well, now is a pretty good time. It's the last quarterfinals, but there are two semifinals coming up today, so if you're enjoying it so far, I can promise you it's only going to get better from here on out.
Oh, yes.
Fallen with a single flashbang. This is the setup that I was sort of introducing this this map with, in fact. They're trying to see if they can sort of pop a flashbang from way back here and then have the people close to the restrooms peek out. But it's not going to be put into play because Taco's alone on the B-bomb side of the USPS. And I think he'd probably prefer right now to be with the rest of his team at least. At least then he'd have some support. This is going to be tough.
Exactly, and a dream. Oh, but the alley's going to ruin the fun. Catches him out. Taco, he was hoping for a little bit of a, you know, sparkles moment there. Just get in the knife, but not gonna happen. And now they just start to close in Luminosity. This is all going to plan for Virtus.Pro. A perfect anti-eco being set up. Cold is the last man alive, and even he gets spotted. So great play here from VP. Showing up now when it matters. Six rounds on the board for them. Very well-handled anti-eco round, but now life gets difficult again. Luminosity, after those rounds of pistols, they're going to be able to buy. They still have enough money for Fallen. This is one thing, you know, that Fallen always has. He always prioritizes that AWP. So even when they go into force buys, Luminosity, he's not spending as much as his teammates just to make sure that he can afford to get that 4750 sniper rifle. But the rest of them, they are just so light on nades right now. And I'm curious. It does look like it's going to be action in mid again for Luminosity. FNX pushing very close. Fur, is there a trap? They aren't necessarily going down into connector. Instead, they're waiting to see if anybody's going to be aggressive here because they put that smoke down, and that's always going to send up alarm bells for VP.
I mean, there is a trap in the sense that Fallen is probably going to be allowed to take the first shot here, and Fur is hiding in a really annoying angle here because it doesn't look like there's much of a corner when you're coming in from the terror side, and you're going to be focused on pretty much everywhere else. That smoke's going to help out, though. Fallen, actually, Molotov's going to be forcing him back now. Fur is out in the open, and he just gets traded. Virtus.Pro, they actually break that hold. That's a very, very impressive use of grenades.
Yes, with a single Molotov. And actually remembering to use it, that's the important bit. Not taking any angles for granted. You have to be willing to make that investment, and it pays off in the end. But Fur still takes one with him, so it shouldn't have been Fur being able to get one kill. It should have been VP just decisively taking control of that part of the map and making that man advantage happen. Instead, now it's FNX to drop the bomb carrier. That's Neo gone. Posh, you know, sidestep into this angle, and he will find the headshot eventually. But they're bringing it back, and Fallen is now the one to make the difference. 3-2 now for Luminosity, and Taco with the shoulder peek onto Long. He spots him out. So confirmation that VP, they're committed. They want to get onto this A site. There's only 35 seconds left.
They don't have a flashbang to go through the smoke either, and that actually makes it a little bit tricky. And you're right, the time as well is really going to be working against them here. Let's see if they can make it through. VP, they can't give up this run back now. They need to go a lot further before they even let Luminosity pick up a round here. Taco is on the other on the one side. Fallen on the other side, and this is looking great. Fallen picking up a second kill, and now all on 10 seconds left. He's rotating around. He needs this kill on Taco quick, and he's trying to try and get the spray, but he can't do it. Taco surviving on 5 health. And that will be a 14th round for Luminosity. And look at this, FNX, Cold Zero, and Fur all tied. They all got 17 kills. This is like a full team effort here for the Brazilian
side. It's full balance as well. It's like a full house because the other two have got 12 kills each. So there you go. Everybody on Luminosity hitting their shots, and then they keep coming through in those clutch situations. How many times have we seen a Luminosity member survive on 1 HP or sub 10? It's just when it gets down to the nitty-gritty, the duel, Luminosity, they're winning all of them nearly.
So does that make it an open-ended straight with 11, 12, 13 on VP side? All right. VP still have money to buy, and that's the crucial thing here. If they had been, you know, forced into an eco here, then the map would probably be over straight away. As we do see, the winners are going to be facing North American Team Liquid in the semifinals. And that is, either way, this is going to be an exciting. Both the semifinals are going to be incredible. That was a good start. Snacks dropping FNX and Fallen. He hits the light post and can't get the kill. He gets tagged down to 28. Small margins here, Semler.
That's what it's all about. Fallen might just be tilting just a little bit there. That was a guaranteed shot from him. He pulled the trigger first, but it's not going to happen in the end. And now they choose to get aggressive on a different part of the map. Taco pushing all the way into T-spawn. Snacks is in position, however.
Oh, he didn't see that.
He misses him. Oh, no. Taco, this could all fall apart for him. And yes, he's so focused on T-spawn. Free kill there for Snacks. And now can Luminosity come back from this? Cold is still alive. Fur only has the MP9, though. Definitely not ideal.
There was just the front of Snacks' foot showing as he walked behind that wall. Cold Sierra gonna win the fight against Snacks. He has still 30 seconds, and it is a 3v4. Luminosity not out of this round yet. Great corner here, but tapping away. He did not have the right rifle for it. That SMG is not that effective at that range. Molotov as well, forcing falling right into Pasha and Cold. He's been playing very well, but I don't think he pulled him out of this one here. Should be a seventh round coming in from Virtus.Pro. Again, damage done to the economy is still a thing. Luminosity, they're not home yet.
No, they are not, because this is going to reset their money down to 1,400 again, and they don't have any bank, Luminosity. So VP, they get a second chance at running it back here. Means that they're going to be running into Luminosity, who will only have pistols in the next round, unless they decide to force again, and they might decide to go for it. Kevlar pistols, they have a huge lead, so why not try and take the risk?
I mean, VP's economy is in a state where you do want to force to sort of, you know, to end the game quick, but do they have the mental strength to allow VP to get back to 12 rounds? You know, the problem is if you start forcing now, you do allow them to get closer and closer. I almost feel like they might want to buy themselves more of a chance of knocking him out here.
Well, Taco, he's only putting, for now he's bought the CZ. Fallen invested a couple $100 in a flash. Yeah, and they are not going to full force, it looks like, here on Luminosity's side. They are going to manage their economy. So I do prefer this method, because it still guarantees a pretty reasonable buy for the rifle round. So let's see how VP decided to challenge this. I mean, deep nade coming in from Pasha to top mid. In case Luminosity were going to try and go for some kind of rush, they'd have had a face full of shrapnel waiting for him, so that was perfect. And they're going with the buddy system as well. Although, as I say that, Pasha is kind of alone right now. Taz isn't really in position to back him up very quickly. Instead, it's going to be four players for Virtus.Pro gathered up outside of B. And that's going to come down to Cold now to try and figure this out. Get his teammates to rotate over, because currently, Luminosity are still trying to set up crossfires in mid.
Pasha having a bit of a presence here, and again, they do have the one flash on Fallen, so as soon as Pasha fires that gun, they're going to be there, but he's actually sneaking so close that that's going to be the start here. Fallen, not even fucking that flashbang for right on the edge, and Pasha, just lethal. Finally, Taco going to be able to get the refrag, but I think Pasha did more than enough there.
Yeah, he draws them out. Cold, not going to be in position to really do too much, although Snacks is kind of holding back here on T-spawn, but it's a clever angle that he's got. And Cold's going to walk right into it, but somehow Cold wins that duel. And we're into a 3-on-3. Cold just sitting and waiting. The AK has been picked up by Taco, but he can hand that over to Fallen, who has more HP.
Yeah, I don't know. They're sort of signaling like they want to go and fight this. I mean, if they want to just get exit frags, that's fine, but I don't see any reason why they try and retake here with a 3-on-3 without any kill or anything like that, but they are certainly making an effort of it. Fallen taking down Taz as well. Neo hitting that shot, and now he just has to hide for as long as he can. He gets the double, and that will be it. So Luminosity, closer than it should have been. Virtus.Pro should have been able to close them out off that round much, much earlier.
Now making it very expensive for Virtus.Pro in the end, with only Neo surviving. And they aren't quite up there, Luminosity, for a full buy, so they're going up to sit. They could have, like, that's the thing, they could have contemplated a buy had they saved a couple of guns going into this round, but they chose to get to, well, they just chose to try and, you know, sometimes you have to take a risk, sometimes you have to go for it. They got offered a free rifle, sure, go for it now. See if you can make some magic happen.
Oh, wow, the crowd certainly is behind them right now. Ash has got 17 kills. Neo has got 17 kills as well. And Luminosity, even with that sort of little bit of a pistol buy last round, they still don't have the money here. You're right, they were really, really hard reset earlier.
And they aren't taking any unnecessary risks. This is all about having a very powerful 24th round and having everything that they need for it. He's going to slow step his way out. Bird misses the shot, though. That looked scary. That looked like it was on, but instead now it's Pasha going to force her out into the open, and free kill for Pasha. Using a little bit of utility just to make their lives easier, but that's how it's done. That's what you're supposed to do. Still very light on the nades for VP, all things considered. They have a lot of money in the bank, so I'm pretty surprised at how low they are already.
Snacks going to be finding Fallen as well. Very, very careful and composed play coming out of Virtus.Pro right now. Seems like all the pressure that they're under right now has just sort of forced them into a state of hyper-focus. They're not really making many mistakes, even in these rounds when they're just playing against pistol and no armor. They're not giving Luminosity many, many options to get back in here. FNX, just going to try and see if he can steal a rifle, I expect. But this will make the scoreline 14-9. I don't know.
And as we saw, the pause has been called. So I imagine this is Luminosity saying, okay, we're about to have our big buy round. It's time to sit down, calm down, get those nerves settled, and just finish this map. Get into those semifinals. Because if VP, they start to pick up steam, that's where it gets difficult for Luminosity. It seems just a little jittery on Luminosity's side right now, so this is the perfect time to go for a timeout. Whereas VP, yeah, this is the perfect anti-eco for them. As far as they're concerned, everything is going according to plan. And you're right, with your back to the wall, you're just going to put everything on the line. Oh. Parting shot. Nicely done. Just a little bit of a bop on the nose there.
It's kind of nice to see that they're actually sticking around to make sure that, there's not some ridiculous, you know, sneak in with a defuse kit or anything like that. Yeah. You know, you could make that mistake at this point in the game when you're... when you've been playing for so long here. Right into the pool. So now what is the game plan? I mean, it seems to be working out quite well for VP. Even if some of these rounds are close, they are winning them. Luminosity on the other hand, how many more tricks up their sleeve do you think they have?
I don't even really think it needs to be a trick up their sleeve. I think they just need to have a minute to just calm down a little bit and settle their nerves, because there isn't necessarily anybody on Luminosity who's just, you know, not delivering right now. They're all kind of hitting the same level. Cold is a little bit ahead, obviously. 21 kills for him. FNX is up there as well. They've kind of cooled off, though. That's the thing. But if they can get them, if they can just, you know, discuss a little bit, all right, what's been going on? Is there anything we can take advantage of here? Has this guy been repeatedly playing this position right? How can we abuse that? Those are the sorts of things that they're discussing right now amongst them, amongst themselves, obviously. But if Cold or FNX Fur, I mean, if these guys just turn up and around, that's all that needs to happen here. So just, you have to appreciate it. Fallen, he knows when to get that timing and when to get that that timing for the tactical timeout to just slow things down and allow for his team to think. VP, the other thing is, and this is where he turns into a bit of a game, you know, do VP change anything? Do VP say, oh, okay, what do we need to do here that's different? When everything is working, you know, VP, it's almost, you almost hear about it sometimes with teams where they're actually like, okay, don't say a word. Because if we overthink things and start changing things while it's already working, that can actually hurt us more than help us. So actually, this whole time out, you don't even say a word right now. Just zen focus.
Six Snacks doing, I think, some talking there at least. And still got the timer going on for just a little while longer here. I don't know, it's hard to guess at what might be going on, because these type of situations, they don't happen too often, right? It's been overtime with the first map, second map was also close. Now, Luminosity, they seem to be just a step away, but the way Virtus.pro are sort of hanging in here, it shows you why, historically as well, if you bring this back to just a bit of history, the original Golden 5 lineup, why they were well known for playing so well in big tournaments, that when it really mattered the most, that's always where they came out of almost nowhere and just managed to make it work. Right. You can feel the energy here at the Nationwide Arena. We are about to get into it once again here. The 24th round is coming up. And VP gonna have to show us what they're really made of. If they want that semi-finals here, this is gonna be the real test.
And yeah, Luminosity haven't really changed much. FNX is taking the peek at long, but he doesn't decide to hang around. One thing actually the Luminosity are not doing here is they're not really going aggressive, actually. I mean, they've been doing a lot of setups in mid, crossfires and restrooms, etc., and we aren't really seeing that. Instead, they've elected to just hang really far back on the A site, playing super passive. And Taco and Fallen, bit of the same thing. Fallen's in a position where he's going to be able to back off a short if they try and rush him there. And Taco's got his back from Toxic. And what a shot from Neo. There we go. He just barely spots out Taco. Gets the wall bang, and now it falls apart for Fallen.
Yeah, what's he going to do at that range with the AWP? I'm really mystified at that setup, because as soon as he, even if he gets a kill, they're all going to be rushing him down. That is a really dangerous setup to have on the B-bomb site. And the rest of Luminosity, they're going to have to just run. They have no chance of retaking this anyway. After a timeout, you take that timeout and you're thinking, let's close out this game, and then Virtus.pro come back with an instant punch right to the face.
And you can see Taco's reaction as well. Nerves getting to him just a little bit there. That's going to be incredibly frustrating, because he barely spots out Neo, and of course Neo's scoped in. It's just probably pixel shot right through the edge of the barrel. But now Ferg, can he actually survive this? They're out hunting, of course, VP. They want to see if they can get these guns off of Luminosity. Two players, Force and Fur. Yeah, he just needs to stay crouched. They aren't going to be able to close the distance fast enough. I mean, this is so long, and they do actually get it. How long is it? It's felt like it lasted forever.
This is the man on camera, one of the all-time Counter-Strike legends.
Ah, great. Let's see. Boom. Yeah.
So that one shot killed the round for Luminosity. That was really all they needed. 14 to 10 is the current scoreline. The 25th round is coming up here.
The man leading the chant is actually going to just like lose his voice, I think. Pretty soon.
I think he'd probably consider it worth it at this point here. I mean, there does seem to be that sixth man effect here. I guess seventh now that we've got Cuban behind, but it's still, this is starting to get, I think it must be nerve-wracking right now for the Luminosity side. Still some distance, and that's the problem here. They gotta keep it cool on the VP side. And usually, and we've got to mention this, we haven't done that yet. Usually what happens is, actually, when you're doing these comebacks, it's first when you tie the scoreline. When you get to 14-14, suddenly you start making mistakes that you hadn't been, you know, for the previous seven rounds. Because that's when it dawns on you, actually, we're actually doing this, you know.
Yeah, we have a chance.
Yeah, it's easier to play without much. Is this real life? Neo taking out Taco, trying to jump up on that ledge.
It's a real pleasure to see Neo playing at this level. Neo hits Fallen up in Sniper. And FNX, he's got that soul rifle, so really he's the one who needs to stay alive. Cold and Fur, they have a little bit of gear coming into it, and FNX will get the drop. Does anybody close enough to be able to pick that up? Maybe eventually Fur can make his way over there to pick up that rifle. But Snax is going to be thinking the same thing. And VP, they don't really need to risk too much here going out on the hunt. They're going to buy in the next round regardless, Luminosity. And so, VP, at this point, it's more about staying alive. Snax is going to be checking some of these angles, but that is all off of Neo once again delivering the entry frag onto that B site. And what's crazy is that Virtus.pro are just being so quiet about this. This is the second time that they've just lurked their way out onto the site. In general, when the terrorist side decide to go onto the B site, they're throwing smokes in, molotovs in, flashes in. It's just like all these flags going up saying this is going to be a B push. Instead, Virtus.pro, back-to-back rounds where they've just snuck their way in. Nothing to announce their presence, just Neo with his op. And it's the second time now that he's delivered. So Luminosity are now going to have to be—they're going to have to question themselves. They might have to actually use their utility earlier than they would like, just to make sure that Virtus.pro aren't capable of doing that anymore.
14-11, Luminosity's lead. It is disappearing round for round here. Just a three-round difference. We're going to put up a classic smoke there, trying to see if he can maybe look over it, which is definitely a good idea. There's nobody there, and if he realizes. Maybe that could be some hint to Luminosity about what's happening here. You got to think right now, Virtus.pro only have to misstep once. It only takes one mistake to let the Brazilians back in the game here. Fur going to come out of the connector and see if he can actually spot out what's going on up at the birthday party. Molotov all the way back. That's a great Molotov. It didn't even touch the ground. It actually explodes mid-air, which is not so easy to do. You got to be on point to get those kind of Molotovs in. They do have a decent stack going on here. Luminosity, three members on the bomb site. But again, you were saying this, not much of a signal that anything is coming, Simon. They're sneaking out along. They still haven't popped any flashbangs. They're creeping onto the bomb site without a signal noise being made. Finally, it's going to begin. Fur picking up that first shot there on Zapasha. And actually, the rest of VP slow it down a bit. You got to think maybe they would have been inclined to push up fast behind that.
It was a perfectly timed flash that just shut them down. Got them to back off and ruined that timing, because now Fur, he's in a better spot. Bialy is now going to have to try and work his way through here without getting shot in the back. Snax is just going to run right into him and actually wins that fight straight up. FNX still on the site, full flashed, however. And good use of the nade so far, VP to create some opportunities for themselves. However, FNX is just going to go ahead and man fight it. One for one trade, Snax and Bialy, and now it's just Bialy in a 1v3. It's just not going to happen. Taco comes out of nowhere and gets all three kills. And it's now four match points for Luminosity. They're on the brink, they're on the edge, and can they keep their cool? That's all that matters at this point. Whereas Virtus.pro, now it's become real, Anders. Now there is no room for error.
No, they have only one option left, and that is play the next four rounds flawlessly. No more mistakes. I mean, the timing there was almost unreal. If Fur doesn't get that opening kill, then they get onto the bomb site without even... They only know that it's an A hit when everybody's on the site here. It looks like Virtus.Pro, this time they do want a little bit of connector control. They're spread out quite far, and they are still very defensive here. So don't want to give anything away.
And they're just waiting to see if Luminosity are going to be getting aggressive anywhere. Cold and Fallen, they will in fact get aggressive by pushing into sewers. And Taco's actually taking a couple of peeks over at Monster, so playing with fire. Neo was waiting around there with the op. That would be perfect. Instead, it's Fallen to find Bialy.
He almost gets the spray in. 16 health on Fallen, but that flick, it is going to make a huge difference here. That's the first opening frag. Now, just crossing the minute mark. They are sneaking up right behind Fur, and if they can't go off guard, that's going to get them back. Fur going to pick up the one kill sprays and almost actually gets the second, but not quite going to happen. Neo picking up Fallen. There's still a 3-on-3 with 50 seconds. They bring the bomb into the bombsite. Taco's on the site. Cole going to be going down now. Everything riding on Taco here. They almost line up. He gets the one spray in. Turns around for it. Second kill, and there it is. The grenades. Half is gone. And Luminosity are in the semis of a major tournament.